welcome back to the show, a little Electric Avenue, a little Eddie Grant.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's an inside joke.
Yeah, is that one of your jams?
Not a joke, it's a great song, but yeah, we talked about it earlier.
I sang that at a karaoke once where the left speaker wasn't working. It was one of those dive bars, and so it was just a beat. So it was like...
a freestyle.
Who is to blame in what country? There was no other music, it was nothing.
Everyone thinks it's like about to come in, but it never comes in.
Never came in, it was awful. I'm so happy you're here. Thank you so much for doing the show. I have a lot of things to talk to you about. First off, Mick Jagger. Obviously, we love Mick Jagger.
Of course.
Yeah, of course. Posted... love Mick Jagger. He posted a video of himself on Instagram dancing to a cover of Maroon 5's song, and it was... Moves Like Jagger.
Pretty awesome. Pretty awesome.
Can you believe this happened?
It's really surreal. Like, it's just one of those things you're like, oh my, like, how is this possible that this is happening? It's bizarre. Many years later, too, you're like, wow.
I didn't think he would ever even do it. I mean, he's the coolest guy. He's fun and awesome. But anyways, take a look. This is him doing it, a little bit of it. I mean, how fun is that? I wonder if, like...
I've never wanted to be the bar band covering it more in my life than that moment.
Can you imagine?
Yeah.
I mean, they must have known he was there and be like, we have to play.
So awesome. It was, like the coolest thing. And then someone sent it to me. And, like, you'd think that, like, a lot of people would have sent me that video.
I was thinking of sending it to you, but I figured everyone...
I think it was one of those, like, everybody thought that everyone had already sent it to me thing.
So no one sent it to you?
Like, my mom and, like, one of my friends sent me the video. And I was like, cool, thanks, cool, love you. But, yeah, I was shocked that not more people sent it to me.
Was it always Moves Like Jagger when you wrote that? You're like, oh, yeah, I just woke up in a dream, like, it's Moves Like Jagger.
I've got it. No, what's crazy about that song is that when we were bouncing ideas around for the song, I think initially it was like from the people who wrote it and the hook, it was he got the Moves Like Jagger, and it was kind of supposed to be for a female artist to sing. I was the only idiot crazy enough to say, like, what if I say I have the Moves Like Jagger? And they were like, are you sure you want to do that? And I'm like, yeah, why not?
Yeah, I got the moves. Like, yeah, why not? What's the worst that could happen? But that was the thing that everyone started saying, I got the moves like Jagger.
It's a confidence thing. It's a swag thing. He's the man. Like, look at him. He's do that, and it's cool somehow.
He's the best. Yeah. You've been hinting that you guys are in the studio working on something, and finally this year you're releasing the new music.
It's coming. I think that for the first time in about 13 years, I've decided to kind of like take the reins back from the songwriting part of it, and kind of I'll make sure that all the ideas come from either myself or the band, so that we're not going to have any real co-writes, and you know, the ideas are coming straight from the nucleus of Maroon 5, which is, I think, going to make it sound a lot like it did in the very, very beginning. So I'm so excited about what's happening right now.
That's going to be big.
They're happy.
Yeah, I'm happy. I can't wait.
So,
last year, you guys released a single called Middle Ground, and your daughters made a cameo in the music video. Very cute. Are they fans? Are they Maroon 5 fans now? Do they come to shows?
They're such historians of every single song we have ever recorded. So much so that they'll bring songs up that I don't remember writing or singing.
Like, oh, really? They know the B-sides and everything.
It's encyclopedic, and it's meticulous, and it's amazing, and I don't know how long it's going to last, but I'm going to enjoy it because it makes me so happy. Like, I'm just going to see how long it takes for them to like other things.
No, they'll love you forever. You're a good dad. Let's talk about this Vegas residency. I'm excited about it. You did this a couple years back, and it sold out. It was a hot ticket, and now you're like, let's just bring it back. Residency in Vegas.
I honestly wasn't really sure about what it was going to feel like to do. It's kind of the opposite of touring, because you're just in the same place every night, and it's Vegas, which is kind of like, you know, when you go play a show all over the place, all over the world, you know, your most hardcore fans in every place you're playing are, you know, they're saving their money, they're marking the date in their calendar. It's you. It's all about Maroon 5. And then when you go to Vegas, they're kind of like choosing you over another person.
They're just like, we happen to be in Vegas.
Hey, it's like Maroon 5.
What do we do?
Or like this, I go with Maroon 5. So it's like a casual, more casual. They may know the songs, but they've never maybe even been to a show. And so it's a new type of crowd to conquer. And so I think that was a nice challenge. But then once we did it and we actually got there and put the show on, I was blown away by the response, but also just it felt great. It was fun to do. It was really different for the band, and I think that kind of injected new life into the way we perform and stuff. So it's great. You guys should come see it.
Is it hard to pick all of your songs? I mean, Payphone, Sugar, This Love, Sunday Morning, She Will Be Loved, Harder to Breathe. Harder to Breathe, I almost forgot. That's a great one, too. Won't Go Home Without You, Girls Like You, Moves Like Jagger, Misery, One More Night. You go all these hits, you go, why not?
It's the best problem ever.
Yeah. I mean,
I love that kind of problem.
And it's a party, and everyone's just there, and they're having. You told me earlier, it's like almost being in like a beautiful giant living room.
It's like your living room. It's when you go on tour, it's a new thing every night, a new bed, a new place, a new backstage, a new venue, and so that adjustment takes like chops. But this is like such an easy thing for us because we go, we know what to expect. The room sounds amazing. It just kind of does feel like home, and I think people like the intimacy of that. People really respond to when we do the shows.
It's gonna be fun. If you're in Vegas, go check out Adam Levine and Maroon 5. For tickets to all of Maroon 5's upcoming shows, including their Las Vegas residency, go to maroon5.com. Adam and I are playing Wheel of Musical Impressions after the break. Hey, hey.